What's happening, everybody? It's Chris here, and we are zooming around the studio. And today, we are zooming around the studio with Jennifer Fitzpatrick. Hello, Jennifer. How are you?
Hi, Chris. How you doing?
I'm good. It's a beautiful day outside, so it's one of those good days. We were talking before, and we're both excited about the better weather coming up, right?
Very excited, and very excited about recreational boating being allowed again.
So we're going to talk about even cooler stuff, the fact that you've got a book, Cruising Through Caregiving, Reducing the Stress of Caring for Loved Ones, and you're focused because you are a gerontology instructor. Am I getting that word right?
Right, yeah.
Okay, cool. At Johns Hopkins, which...
This is my 11th semester. We just wrapped up spring semester, had to convert everything to online programming in the middle of the semester, but yeah, we got through it. Just, I know so many college students have gone through that, graduate school students, and it's especially tough for people that were graduating, you know, high school seniors and college seniors. But I just went through that with my class at Johns Hopkins as well.
So, well, let's talk about more like about your book and about what you've actually been doing. And what are some of like, I guess, some of the biggest like stressors, especially nowadays, that caregivers are facing during this time?
Well, I put them into two categories. Either one, you're not seeing your loved one enough, and you're concerned about that, or two, you're seeing a little bit too much of your loved one, and that's stressful too. So I want to just put it out there to anybody who's not caregiving, think about it. Whoever you're social distancing with, you probably have had moments where you're getting on each other's nerves a little bit. Maybe it's just at my house. But think about it. If you're taking care of a loved one who is sick or has dementia or has a number of health ailments, and you are really one of the only people that can see that person right now, it's hard to bring family and friends in because of social distancing. That's an enormous stressor. So there's that one end. And then we've got the other end where you might have a loved one who maybe lives 5 miles away, but you're social distancing from them, but they need help. They still need to get to some essential medical appointments, or they really can't go to the grocery. But even still, then there's folks that if they're in a nursing home or an assisted living, and then you can't see them at all, that's a stressor. So usually it's fallen in one of those two categories of too much, and the stress of, gosh, I need a break, or the stress of, gosh, I feel like I can't do enough and I can't keep tabs on my loved one enough. But just know that this, we have to just remind ourselves constantly that this situation is temporary. It doesn't feel like it. It's incredibly stressful, but whatever stressor you're dealing with, you're going to either be able to get some breaks and get some help at some point, or if you haven't been able to see your loved one, you are going to be able to see them at some point.
What advice would you give to people in both those categories? I mean, you have the people that are stuck at home, and you also have the people that can't see their loved ones. So what advice would you give for them?
So for one, just, I feel like the mantra has to be, this is temporary. We're going to get through it. So I always repeat that, because I know people are getting restless. I don't think anybody imagined that we would be doing this stay at home for so long. Remind yourself that it's temporary, but I want you to be thinking about, okay, when all of this passes, what are you going to do differently? So for some people, maybe they've been limited access for their loved one who's in assisted living or nursing home, and maybe they are able to drive and do a window visit, or they're just doing phone calls, or maybe they've taught their loved one how to use Zoom or FaceTime or something like that, which is great. But I want you to be thinking about, after all this passes, what are you going to do differently? Because think about it. It might be, maybe you are one of those people that your spouse is in a nursing home and you feel like you have to be there every day. Maybe this is a lesson that maybe going 3 times a week is okay. You know, once all of this is lifted and you can visit your loved one. Because I see a lot of family members back before COVID started, that they would go every day and be 8 hours, 10 hours at the nursing home or assisted living, and they wouldn't have any life of their own. And so I think there's an opportunity right now to say, after all this passes, what could I do a little bit differently so I have quality of life and they have quality of life? For those people who are doing it at home, you're doing that social distancing at home with your loved one, some things that you can do, I want you to be thinking about, number one, a lot of home care agencies are still allowing, you can hire an aide. So they're working safely, but you can still do that. I know adult days are closed, but Also, if it's too much, especially if you have a loved one who has Alzheimer's or another type of dementia, it might be too much. And this might be the time that you do have to look at senior living or nursing home. And I know that there are many organizations are not admitting new residents, but some are. And so it's something to think about. And even if you're not comfortable doing it now, is it something that you want to do when we get to that new normal? Is it that this has been just too much? So for example, the other day I was talking to a woman who, it was probably the first week of the stay-at-home order, and her mom had been going to adult daycare. And it was a great setup. Mom has dementia. She goes to adult day 5 days a week. And the woman was, now she has to work from home. Well, now it's she and her mom at home all day, every day. The woman has to work. Her mom doesn't really have anything to do. And there was a day where her mother literally tried to escape out the window of the house. That kind of stress is just, I mean, you gotta look at what makes sense. Like, can you look at home care? Is it possible to look at senior living after this? Or what kinds of activities can you engage your loved one in right now so they're not exhibiting some of those behaviors?
What kind of resources would you recommend for people who are looking for, like, I know, like, your book, obviously, it's probably a great resource. And there's also there's a webpage you have, like, was it Generations?
So cruisingthroughcaregiving.com has all the worksheets from the book and also a free chapter. By the way, you can order the book if you would like from Amazon or Barnes & Noble, but in Queen Anne's County Libraries, the Kindle version. So you can just order it from the library and have it come to your Kindle. Most libraries in Maryland do have it, which is great. But in addition, there's a few resources. So for one, I'm just going to say real quickly, when I say have a routine, try to take advantage of good weather. You and I, Chris, were talking about this before mm-hmm. we started. We don't know, tomorrow could be raining. I mean, for heaven's sakes, in New England earlier this week, it was snowing. Get your loved one outside, get them exercise. One of the things that I said to that woman who was working her job from home and trying to take care of mom, I said to her, get mom out of the house, get her exercising as much as you can, because she's used to a full day at the adult daycare. Mm-hmm. I know, like, you've got work to do, you got your job to do, but most employers are being pretty flexible right now. They understand people are homeschooling their kids, they got elderly parents at home, but play music, put on old movies that your mom likes. What the kiss of death is really for any of us is when we're sitting on the couch all day, every day, watching TV and dozing. That's the worst that any of us can be doing. Now, if you've got a bad cold and one day you want to watch Law & Order SVU marathons, which I've been guilty of.
We've all been there, yeah.
For a day, but it's a luxury. For one day, that's awesome. It's like, oh, this is great. I can watch. I like the ones with Detective Stabler. You watch that, it's great. But when it's day in and day out, and you got to get your loved one engaged in something, whether you guys bake together, but music penetrates the long-term memory. Mm-hmm. So if your loved one doesn't have cognitive impairment, the same thing is true. One thing that I recommend, and I have an exercise in Cruising Through Caregiving on how to figure out people that can help you with this. It's called the MET exercise. And again, you can download that at cruisingthroughcaregiving.com. All of that's free. But it's how to find people in your friend and family network who can help you with some tasks. So right now, maybe they can't come over and stay with your mom while you go get your nails done. Because as of right now, when we're taping, there's nowhere you can get your nails done. So you're not going to do that. But maybe you can enlist like 5 people in your friend and family network to give your mom a call once a week. So she has distraction. She's talking to somebody new. Don't underestimate the power of the phone right now. I think a lot of us are like, oh, we got to do FaceTime. We got to do Zoom. We got to do Skype. Mm-hmm. That's great, but the oldest generation is often just going to be more comfortable just the traditional old school telephone. It's in, especially if there's memory issues, it's in their long-term memory. Mm-hmm. But as far as other resources, there are countless online support groups. There are the Alzheimer's Association. If your loved one has dementia, they're still open at the 800 number 24 hours a day. You can ask any question. I used to work with them for many years, but their number is 800-272-3900, 800-272-3900, and they are open 24 hours a day. I'm not saying that they can fix all your problems, but if your loved one is jumping out the window, they can give you some ideas on how to de-escalate. Another great resource right now is Queen Anne's County Department of Aging. And that's a place that you can go. You can call them for support. You know, they're not able to do everything, like senior centers aren't open, but they still have supportive programs. Another great resource that I love, and I actually happen to be on the care advisory board for an organization called HFC. And it's a nonprofit that was started by the actor Seth Rogen and his wife, Lauren Miller Rogen. And their website is wearehfc.org, wearehfc.org. And what they do, it's actually, Chris, it's actually kind of amazing. Mm-hmm. They provide grants for people to keep their loved one with dementia at home. They provide up to 24 hours a week for up to 6 months for somebody to keep their loved one at home. And this is not just for folks that are indigent or that are Medicaid eligible. It's for middle-class folks can apply for these grants as well. So wearehfc.org, it's a really special organization. I don't know of any other organization that provides that level of care. So you can apply for a grant. They're still funding grants during COVID too.
Well, thank you so much. Is there anything else you want to kind of leave the people with? Like any other like advice or anything else out there?
The only thing that I would say is remind yourself that this is temporary. I know that it's hard to believe, but plan on what you're going to do differently once adult day opens up, once friends and family can visit. Are you going to let more people in to your home to help you? Are you, when think about, even if you're not taking care of a loved one who has dementia, whoever you're living with, the odds are they're getting sick of you. You're getting a little sick of them. If you're caring for somebody who's dependent on you and you know, you're probably like, oh gosh, this is, I'm getting burnout. I'm getting tired. They're also getting tired of you. Okay. So bring in help, utilize when adult day opens back up, utilize it, consider utilizing home care, look at senior living for the long term. Even if things are working great today, know that you might need other resources in the future. And if you'd like to get a free copy of Cruising Through Caregiving, the free chapter, just go to cruisingthroughcaregiving.com, all the worksheets, and the book is available at Queen Anne's County Library in the Kindle version if you want to download it there.
Awesome. Well, yeah. And that book again is Cruising Through Caregiving, Reducing the Stress of Caring for Your Loved Ones. Jennifer L. Fitzpatrick, the author, person I'm speaking to right now. So Jennifer, thank you so much.
For Thanks, Chris.
And if you do go out boating today, have fun.
Stay safe. Thank you.
Good stuff. So, all right. Well, and thank you guys for watching, and we will see you soon.